We're going to use 6 balloons to make a ball. Inflate all balloons, leaving a 5-inch flat tail. Let's twist a chain of 5 bubbles. We are going to twist all bubbles of the same size. It could be any size, up to 3-inch. We are going to use a pentagon shape as a pattern for our sculpture. Lock both ends of the chain of the first 5 bubbles in one lock twist. We have made the pentagon. Twist a chain of next 5 bubbles. We use each balloon to twist 10 bubbles to make 2 connected pentagons. And you're absolutely right. 2 connected pentagons make 1 digit 8. That is what we are doing right now. Lock both ends of the chain of the last 5 bubbles in one lock twist. The rest of the blue balloon is the 11th bubble. We don't need it. You can cut it off with your fingers or scissors. Tie off the end. We have made the second blue pentagon and the first digit 8. We have to twist 5 digits 8 to make the helmet. We will connect all digits 8 to each other. Twist the first yellow bubble. Lock the free end of the first yellow bubble between the first and the second blue bubbles on the right side of the top blue pentagon. Twist the second yellow bubble. Lock the free end of the second yellow bubble between, let's assume, 6 and the 7th blue bubbles. So the second yellow bubble is connected to both blue pentagons. Twist a chain of 3 yellow bubbles. Lock both ends of the chain of the first 5 yellow bubbles in one lock twist. We made the first yellow pentagon. Now let's twist the 6th yellow bubble. We are going to lock the free end of the 6th yellow bubble between the 2nd and the 3rd blue bubbles. Oops, I have to twist the yellow bubble again. Force the yellow balloon through the loop of the first 5 bubbles and lock it. Okay. Twist a chain of 4 yellow bubbles. Since I mentioned before that we have to twist 5 digits 8 to make the helmet and 6 digits 8 to make the hat. Oh boy, we're good. Lock both ends of the chain of the last 5 yellow bubbles in one lock twist. We have made the second digit 8. Cut off the rest of the yellow balloon. Tie off the end. The next 2 balloons we're going to twist and attach to each other in the same fashion as we did the first 2. Let's use the gray balloon to twist the 3rd digit 8 and attach it to the yellow digit 8. Of course, we can use just one color balloons to make this sculpture. However, it could be a bit confusing, especially if you do this sculpture first time. It is simple to make the pentagon. It is simple to make the digit 8. The confusing part, well, at least for me, it is to connect all digits 8 in the shape of a ball. Okay, lock both ends of the chain of the first 5 gray bubbles in one lock twist. When we use different colored balloons, it makes our job much easier. It's easy to figure out where you have to make the connections. And the sculpture will look beautiful, colorful. Here we twist a chain of 4 gray bubbles. Now we lock both ends of the chain of the last five gray bubbles in one lock twist. We have made the third digit 8. Cut off the rest of the gray balloon and tie off the end. Let's use a pink balloon to twist the fourth digit 8 and attach it to the gray balloon. We do it in the same fashion as we did previously. We can use this technique and this pattern to make various sculptures of very large size. The size of bubbles is really matter for making a helmet of right size. For example, a helmet made of 1-inch bubbles hardly would fit a head of a 2-year-old child. Well, at least it doesn't fit my boy. And the helmet made of 3-inch bubbles is a bit large for my medium-sized bald head. However, it would fit perfectly well the same medium-sized head with a ponytail. Once you made a couple helmets for practice, you'll be able to figure out with ease the right size bubbles for all future sculptures. So far we were attaching all digits 8 sidewise. Our next step is to attach the top of all four digits 8 with one pentagon. Here you can see the four digits 8 connected to each other sidewise. Cut off the rest of the pink balloon, tie off the end. We can trim off the knots or just hide them between bubbles. Now we are going to use a brown balloon. I think it is important to notice. I hold the blue balloon on left, pink balloon is on right. So the blue digit 8, if we hold it vertically, will be in the lower part of our sculpture. Twist the first brown bubble. Lock the free end of the first brown bubble between the third and the fourth blue bubbles. Twist the second brown bubble. Lock the free end of the second brown bubble between the only two available yellow bubbles on the top of the sculpture. Twist the third brown bubble. Lock the free end of the third brown bubble between the two gray bubbles on the top of the sculpture. Twist the fourth brown bubble. Lock the free end of the fourth brown bubble between the next two pink bubbles. Twist the fifth brown bubble. Lock both ends of the chain of first five brown bubbles in one lock twist. We made the first brown pentagon. Our next step is to make the second brown pentagon and connect it sidewise, first with blue digit 8 and then with pink digit 8. So here we're going to make first connection clockwise to the blue balloon. Twist the sixth brown bubble. Lock the free end of the sixth brown bubble between the next two blue bubbles. Twist the seventh brown bubble, lock the free end of the seventh brown bubble between the next two blue bubbles. Now we twist a chain of two brown bubbles. Here's the eighth brown bubble. Twist the ninth brown bubble. Lock the free end of the chain of the last two brown bubbles between two pink bubbles located right next to the brown balloon. Twist the tenth brown bubble. Lock both ends of the chain of the last five brown bubbles in one lock twist. Okay, we have made the fifth, the brown digit 8. Cut off the rest of the brown balloon and tie off the end. Tying knots could be very time consuming, but it is something that we have to do. Let's pull the bubbles apart slightly to fix them in proper position. We have made a helmet. Let's take a look on our helmet. We can use a helmet as a base to make many different sculptures, like wigs, hats, vases, and of course balls. Yes, we have to twist and connect one more digit 8 to make a ball. So we have here 3 blue bubbles, 2 brown, 2 pink, 3 pink and 2 gray, 2 yellow. Okay, we will make first connection between 2 blue bubbles. Twist the first green bubble. Lock the free end of the first green bubble between 2 blue bubbles next to the brown balloon. Twist the second green bubble. Lock the free end of the second green bubble between the next two brown bubbles. Twist the third green bubble. Lock the free end of the third green bubble between the next two pink bubbles. Twist the fourth green bubble. Lock the free end of the fourth green bubble between the next two pink bubbles. Twist the fifth green bubble. Lock both ends of the chain of the first five green bubbles in one lock twist. We made the first green pentagon. The last pentagon will connect all balloons together. Twist the sixth green bubble. like the free end of the 6th green bubble between the next 2 blue bubbles. Twist the 7th green bubble like the free end of the 7th green bubble between the next 2 yellow bubbles. Twist the 8th green bubble like the free end of the 8th green bubble between the next 2 gray bubbles. Twist the 9th green bubble like the free end of the 9th green bubble between the next 2 pink bubbles. We can use the ball as a hiding place for smaller items. And it's the last chance you can put it in, I guess. And finally twist the 10th green bubble. Lock both ends of the chain of the last 5 green bubbles in one lock twist. Congratulations, we have made the ball. Let's count what we used to make this ball. We used 6 balloons. Twisted 60 bubbles to make 6 digits 8 or 12 pentagons. Of course we can cut off the rest of the green balloon and tie off the end. Obviously we can use much more balloons, up to 60, to make balls of bigger size using exactly the same pattern, pentagon shape. This sculpture is very durable. It's fun to play indoor. Let's look around this sculpture. We can use pentagon pattern with less than 6 balloons to make balls. Next time I will show you how this ball can be done with 3 balloons, with 4 balloons. Here Daniel shows us the helmet. For this helmet I use 2-inch bubbles. Here's the side view, the front view, the side view, the top view. And here's the ball. We made it with 3-inch bubbles. Have fun and happy twisting!